Hey guys, and welcome to another Dr. Phil video.
Bruh.
Look, it's just one video, alright? It's February, my ad revenue's terrible. Look, just one more video, please, alright? I'll even use the green screen to make it look like I'm putting effort in. So, in today's Dr. Phil video, there is an insane woman on the show, which is basically every Dr. Phil episode ever.
I don't like being asked multiple questions.
Cause then you piss me off, and then I get mad.
Catch me outside, how about that?
Dr. Phil says bad person bad, you watch for free.
How generous.
Don't kill yourself.
But instead of it being a teenager, it's a fully grown woman. So you really can't blame adolescence on the thing she's about to say.
So you ask people, this is 2.5 cups. And you want people to build up to drinking a gallon of this a day.
Right, because the thing is, people are very malnourished.
This is Jillian Mythe, creator of her very own Jilly Juice. Now, the Jilly Juice is an alternative therapy treatment. What you're meant to do is drink a gallon of this every single day. It's meant to cure autism, cancer, and apparently homosexuality. Because in Jillian's eyes, being gay, lesbian, or trans is a mutation of the body.
Reverse homosexuality?
Yes!
I found one of her Facebook posts. Is our society ready to accept that gay, lesbian, and transgender is a mutation of the human body? I love all my gay friends. Ugh. I know a black guy, I'm not racist.
This is just cringe.
What's going on is you're so immunocompromised, you're not absorbing all the nutrition. That's why you see mutation from people. And so, when you
Also, I spent about 20 minutes looking up any case studies to what she just said. There's nothing.
When you actually flood your system, you're actually feeding your body what it wasn't ordinarily getting, because you're being undermined by parasites, you're being undermined by all the different toxins that are attacking you at the cellular level.
You can tell that she's the kind of woman that thinks a juice cleanse is a legitimate thing that detoxifies the body, even though there's about 30 studies right now proving how BS they are. Don't do a juice cleanse, by the way. If you got a family or relative that does it, let them die early. But you've got a long life ahead of you.
Your claims are that you can regrow organs and limbs.
Right. If you can heal a cut on your arm, that's your integumentary system, right? These are cells that are regrowing. So how can that not be a leap to go into regrowing your organs?
Now she says that the Jilly Juice can reverse aging and completely regrow limbs. This is the part where you think, is she baiting and pretending to be retarded, or is she actually retarded? There's a very fine line she's walking here.
I know I can drink more than one sip of water. It's just disgusting.
Either way, she's a complete lobotomite. You cannot reverse aging. I think the only example of you reversing aging is if you went through a massive dose of stress in your life, and then you actually came back on that and recovered. You'd look a bit younger, but that stress would have to make you physically look 55 when you're 9. Me, when someone destroys my Minecraft house, oh my god. I like the idea of regrowing limbs though. It's so obvious that she saw someone playing, like, I don't know, Call of Duty World at War. Someone's legs got blown off by a grenade. Whoa. Hold on a minute. He respawned and he has his limbs back. Oh my god, this is real life. Video games are an extension of reality, guys. Come on.
Shut up. You acknowledge that they're gonna feel really not great when they start drinking this.
What I'm acknowledging is that we're redefining the role of pain in our world, because what you do with pain right now is you squelch it with a pill, powder, something, or opioid.
Okay,
right?
But you're saying they're not gonna feel well when they drink this
at first.
They're
gonna feel, they're gonna feel healing.
Pain equals healing. If I catch my wife cheating on me with another man, is that healing? I know it's really easy for us commentary channels to just rip into people on the other side of the planet. It's a kind of cowardly thing to do. So I want to meet Jillian halfway and actually go ahead and recreate her Jilly Juice.
Okay guys, so today I'm going to be creating the Jilly Juice potion from Fortnite.
No, it's not from Fortnite.
So to begin, we're gonna need some kale or cabbage.
Wait, that's not fucking kale.
Okay, so for this, we're gonna need some kale and some pink Himalayan salt. This was so hard to get hold of.
Fuck you, Jamie Oliver.
So to begin, just get a nice handful of it, you know, just take it out, and then we drop it inside.
Yeah.
There we can see the kale sitting pretty comfortably. Now all we need is some tap water. Now for the next part, you're gonna need some salt. One tablespoon is required, so I'm just going to add a tablespoon in. It's not really... There's about a tablespoon in there, give or take. That's actually going to fucking kill someone. Now what we have to do is put it back onto the mixer, switch it on, and then blend.
You will lose everything.
Now guys, we're finally ready to have our chili juice. Now there's a little snafu. The problem is the chili juice is actually meant to ferment for 3 days. So I'll see you guys in 3 days' time. Hey guys, I'm back 3 days later, wearing the same clothes. And here we have our chili juice, completely perfected. Smells lovely. Now guys, I'm gonna drink the chili juice and see if the chili juice protocol really works. Wow guys, I gotta be honest, I didn't have my hopes up, but the chili juice has really helped invigorate me. Goodbye Jillian, down the drain you go.
Woo! That's freaking intense.
I can feel my cells killing themselves. Now, it's apparent that the chili juice isn't that healthy for you. In fact, it actually promotes profuse diarrhea, which she has dubbed waterfalling.
I want to just really quickly go over the difference between waterfalls and diarrhea so there is no mistake about the difference between the two, because they are not the same. There is an action that is going on, but you have to know what precipitated the event to begin with.
Poo-poo diarrhea. Pee-pee.
So you don't have any proof that this really grows on.
Proof is all relative. I've seen proof in smaller experiential circumstances.
It's not relative. You have proof, you don't.
No, proof is relative.
Do you have any training?
Hold on a second. If you
do you have any training?
I have enough training.
I love how nuanced she is with her answers. Take every single politician in human history. Well, current Prime Minister of the United Kingdom, what do you think about the events of World War
II? Do we live on a planet? Well, I'll answer your question by asking you one.
So I drink this, and that arm is just going to regrow.
Well, here's the thing. I know you're mocking me, but I get it.
Why are the chairs so huge? They both look like toddlers at McDonald's. I really don't get American culture. You guys have chairs that are 7 feet tall, and you stole rugby from us and turned it into the most profitable sport in human history.
If you heal your cut on your arm, right? You see the skin.
I'm just asking.
Yes, you can regrow it potentially.
So if I get a cut on my arm, it's the equivalent to losing my whole arm. It makes sense, really. You do understand that mammals cannot regrow limbs. Our biological structures are way too complex for that. You're comparing a human body to someone's pet axolotl. The amount of control your body would need to regrow a limb in the exact same way without it looking like a deformed mess. If we had the ability to regrow limbs now, we'd all look like Birkin from Resident Evil 2.
You say we can live to 400 years old.
Yes.
And cancer, yeah. You can just reverse cancer. Any kind of cancer.
Of course, cancer's a fungus.
Cancer is a fungus.
Of course, I should be in Arkham Asylum, of course.
Whoa. Hey, what are you doing? Get out of here. No, you're not gonna try it. Out.
I love how you got Prospector Pete there, trying to live to 400 by drinking the chili juice. Very obviously a plant by Jillian, or just mentally insane. I mean, it's the Dr. Phil audience, it's basically the same thing.
I think you saying this about reversing homosexuality is outrageous and offensive.
It can be, yes.
No, it is offensive, you lobotomite. It legitimately is offensive. Don't pull that YouTube apology like, I'm sorry you feel that way. You know,
I had a severe lapse in judgment.
Buy my merch, guys. Also, I did a bit more digging on her Facebook page. Found this.
Here's the change I've experienced on the protocol, Jillian. Before, after.
Wow, two different pictures that have no actual consistency at all. The picture on the top left, you can't even tell. They could have just swapped it out with a man. You don't even know. Yeah, let me compare 144p image to 4K image. It's a good comparison. Here is me before chili juice. Here is me after chili juice. Wow, so epic.
Don't put a picture of me fat. You're gonna fucking asshole, you're gonna do it.
Now guys, I have some unepic news. The chili juice did actually kill someone. Allegedly. There was a guy called Bruce Wilmot and he actually died while taking the chili juice protocol. And of course, your girl Jillian was so quick to go onto Facebook and remove any association with it. By the way, everybody, if you heard rumors about a Bruce Wilmot dying in a protocol, just so you know, he had pancreatic cancer and was in hospice and would have tried everything before he gave up. Now, that part of the Facebook post is actually legitimate. She's explaining that the guy had a terminal aggressive disease. That's fine. It was out of her control. If she ended the post there, it would have been fine. But then she goes on to say, the only reason he died is because he stopped taking the chili juice. It's also nice to know that when she's talking about someone's death, she plugged in her merch at the very end of the post.
How generous.
Also, if you didn't gather already, chili juice, much like its creator, Jillian, is packed with salt. Each chili juice needs to have a tablespoon of salt. Keep in mind, the daily recommended amount of salt is just under a tablespoon. Too much salt can raise your blood pressure, it puts strain on your kidneys, your heart, your brain. It can even cause stuff like a stroke. Now, why am I telling you this when Dr. Phil went to the extent of getting an actual doctor just to shut her down with facts and logic?
Well, Kaylin says Jilly Juice caused her to suffer two strokes, but when she complained, Jillian called her a fearmonger and blocked her from the online group.
What's that? Dying in the family WhatsApp group? Blocked. I'll have no one dying in my family group. You're all so selfish.
But the amount of sodium is 40%. It is just the same. And it is the sodium that we are worried about in this concoction. Look, the medical community does not pretend to have all the answers.
Yes, they do.
No, they don't.
Yes, they do. Right here, case in point.
Are they laughing at her proving herself wrong, or are they laughing at how high the chairs are? So guys, now we enter the final act. Dark Souls 3. The people that are mentally insane enough to support Jilly Juice.
When I started researching Jillian, I looked at her group, I read her book, I poured through all of her videos, and I found a disturbing trend of what felt like a narcissistic cult leader.
I spent about $800 a month on all the food, the supplements, in the hope that it will help. But I found it helps about 45 to 50% max.
Oh, the medically approved stuff only helps you 50% of the time. Half the time, it's not that great. Oh, you shrunk my tumor by 50%, but chili juice can shrink it by 80%, doctor. I love how she's doing that thing as well that I talked about literally 3 minutes ago. Like, you've got the picture of her looking really bad and just in discomfort. And then, like, she's saying she's improved and she's wearing makeup.
My son has autism and my daughter has ADHD. Since being on chili juice, my son has been tested and he is in moderate autism. Prior to that, his symptoms were showing severe autism. For my daughter, her grades have gone up.
Yeah, you don't mention the possible medication that your kids are taking on the side. Reeling? We dunk it in the chili juice. Also, you fail to mention any support they'll be getting at school, any special educational needs they'll be getting. They're just drinking rotten cabbage. It makes their brain grow to such a size, it presses against their skull.
And did your body have a big reaction to it when you started?
Oh, definitely.
Did you have these waterfalls?
Oh, definitely.
It gives you diarrhea.
Oh, definitely.
I edited that, okay? It was a meme. Shut up.
Not diarrhea. It's called waterfalls because it's different context, different intention, and different outcome.
So if I poured gasoline on a man, set him on fire, and then kicked him to put the fire out, then just say it's a joke. It goes from attempted first degree murder to a prank. This woman is a genius.
We're different.
No, we're not different. I'm right and you're wrong. That's
right. Hey, we get it. We're on his show. Okay, I get it.
No, you don't.
She's just noticed now it's the Dr. Phil show. She's just noticed the watermark in the bottom left corner. Guys, I've come to the decision. I will now watermark all of my videos. It will be here, it will stay here, and it will be epic.
Violently peeing out your butt supposed to help your immune system.
I have a question. Have you tried it?
No.
Okay, there you go.
Oh, no.
There you go. That's the answer. You're not going to know unless
Angie,
you try it.
Have you tried heroin before? Do you want to look like the Joker's final form in Batman Arkham Asylum? You won't know until you try it. And that concludes the saga of Jilly Juice. I can still feel it in my gut right now. Please, guys, subscribe if you're new to the channel. That would be epic. I want to build an army of stans so we can storm into James Charles' house and force him to do a collab of Fortnite with me. So guys, let me leave you with a question. What did we learn in today's video? Drink your body weight in salt for a chance to become every commentary YouTuber ever.